In this video, we're going to build a fully functional app using Lovable. I've had this business idea for a little while where I want to use AI to suggest credit cards for people based on a quiz that users enter information about themselves with. And then the business model eventually could be to earn affiliate revenue by recommending credit cards to users based on their quiz. So let me write a prompt here, and then I'll let you know what we came up with. So I'm gonna say, I want to create a credit card recommendation quiz with one question per page, similar to a quiz from Lemonade, which is an insurance company. And I attach an image of what their quiz looked like to ask about spending habits and needs, and then we can recommend a credit card. So I had some question ideas as well. So let me also change this to private. And let's go ahead and get started. All right, so let's test out the quiz that it generated. So I like how it added these animations. Really nice that it started it at 17%. It shouldn't be able to go back because we haven't started yet, but that is an option here. What's your annual income? Interesting that it has pounds here and everything else is in dollars. So actually, let's use the new edit feature here and let's change that. Click in, and let's see, I can't edit text directly here, interestingly. Probably because it's not static. So we can do that later. So let me just select one. Interesting, looks like that should be checked, but doesn't really matter. Where do you spend the most? Okay. What's your primary reason for a new card? Earn rewards, credit, balance transfer, interest rate. Okay. Can select this. And travel. Okay, cool. So overall, I think that's a pretty good start. So let's think about how we can improve this more. So now what I'm gonna say is, let's now add a results page. Here are credit card. And their information. Let's use a ranking system to decide what to recommend. And then what I'm gonna do is I went into ChatGPT 03 mini high with the search functionality, and I'm asking it to create a table for me, which I'm going to paste into this chat. So if we just give it a second here, it's just generating the table. Not bad. Okay, so it has 8 options. So I'm gonna go ahead and copy the table. I'm gonna say, here is the table. And let's go ahead and submit. So we can see here's the table. It's obviously not formatted great, but the AI should be okay with it. But we're gonna get the card, the company, the credit score, annual fee, and the benefits as well, and then also a sign-up link. So it's gonna help us create a results page that recommends credit cards based on the user's quiz answers. And it's also gonna create a ranking system to match user preferences with card features. Okay. All right, so it says now it's created a comprehensive results page, and we can see what that looks like here. And awesome. Okay, cool. So I guess that's, if we go back to the index page, let's see if we can test this out. So let's just put some answers in here. And say I want to earn rewards. Let's say I'm willing to have a premium annual fee. I travel frequently. And there we go. So here's the recommendations, and it's giving me a card with high earning and an annual fee. So all of these have annual fees, but they also have higher perks. So this actually did work, which is pretty cool. I do wish that it had more information about why this card and more about the perks. So I'm going to say, on the recommendation page, please include more information about the perks. of each card. Okay. All right, so it says it has better recommendations, so or improve that page. So let's just fill this out really quickly. And let's say no annual fee. Never. Okay, there we go. So now, yes, it has more benefits. This one doesn't have any key benefits. This one has high cashback potential. Discover its student cashback, secure credit card. Okay, it makes sense that this doesn't really have any benefits. This is a very basic card. And yeah, so that's pretty cool. And then if I click apply now, it doesn't look like it's taking me to that link. So we could make sure that the correct link goes in there. But overall, that is pretty cool. So all right, let's make some more improvements here. All right, so I used ChatGPT to help me come up with some more ideas here to make the quiz more fun and engaging. So we're gonna try to add rewards and badges, more personality to the question copy, more color and fun animations, a welcome page to make the user see why it's worth taking the quiz, a combination of multiple choice, true, false, and rating scales, and then including polls where users can see what others who voted are thinking in real time about personal finance. And this will be not included in the credit card recommendation algorithm, but just for fun. Okay, so let's let Lovable build this out and come back once it's finished. All right, so let's go through it. I already really like what it did. I think this is kind of cool. Maybe that should be centered, but actually, let's see if I click edit, am I able to do, I'm still learning everything I can do about editing here. Like if I click on that, I can change the padding and the size. Okay, so I might not be able to change the centering of it. But anyway, we can always do that later. I'm gonna exit. But yeah, I really like that. I like the animation. Let's click start quiz. All right, cool. Let's start with your credit score. Did you know the highest possible credit is 850? This is pretty cool. this is actually really awesome. And we got a little badge for doing that. Okay, it's adding points every time. So let me just make some notes here. On the multiple choice, remove the circle on the right of the box because it's not being filled in. Every time I click on a badge that has points, it keeps adding. Only add once per question if the user is selected on it and clicks next. Okay, let's keep testing it though. Let's hit next. I like how it kind of has these fun facts. This is kind of cool. This design is probably going to be most appealing to like maybe Gen Z. It's funny that you're getting points based on how much money you make. I'm not sure if I love that, but I think it's interesting. Where does your money like to party? I feel like there's something kind of cool about the badges, but it's just not, I don't know if it's exactly working. And then cool, a little quiz. I like that it added that in the middle. Okay, primary reason. Preferences. Okay, personalized credit card recommendations. And then there we go. Okay, so we have that. I'm gonna also say on the recommendation page, make sure the design matches the rest of the app. Okay, let's go ahead and ask for those updates. All right, let's see how it did here. Okay, good, it removed that. I think that's better. It's also not adding the points, but it's still giving it to me if I click on it, so, and I still have 100 points. So I need to say for the points, remove Don't add it. Remove them if I click away from the option with points. All right, so let's try it out again. All right. If I add the points, but I take them away, so that's all working. Very cool. Let's say groceries and dining. And then let's say I want to earn rewards. Oh, whoops, what happened? I don't know if there was a bug or something. Earn rewards if I hit next. This is where it broke. So I guess it's where I don't know what happened there. Okay, cool. Kind of awesome. All right. So I'm gonna make one more update. I'm gonna say let's get rid of the points because I don't think they have a real purpose. But let's add badges to all the answers. So no matter what, the user collects badges. And then as end, the badges should show up on the quiz as they go along. Okay. All right, so let's see how it did here. Let's start the quiz. All right, so now we have different badges for everyone. And as we select it, it's adding the badge. So it looks like the same issue is happening where, okay, so where it's adding multiple badges, kind of like it was with the points. So we're going to say only add the badge of the option selected. Remove if not selected. Okay. So while it's doing that, I'm just going to keep going. So yeah, it just keeps giving us these badges. I like how it's doing this though. So we'll hit next. I like the quiz. Okay. And then yeah, those I like actually really like that, but let's let it remove so it's not going to add for every option you select. And then I think it's going to be a much better shape. Okay, so it says it updated it. Let's try this one more time. Start quiz. Okay, cool. So yeah, now it's only giving me the badge that I should get. Okay, entertainment. I like how it has this little quiz. Okay, cool. Awesome. And let's see how this looks on mobile. Okay, so on mobile. Let me take the whole thing again really quick on mobile. So overall, I think it's okay. The only issue might be, let's see, let's just go through really quickly. So on mobile, what I'm just going to do is take a picture of this. On mobile, the tags on the recommendation page, need to be responsive. Maybe even just, well, yeah, how about just responsive? Okay. And there we go. Awesome. That looks a lot better. Cool. This is great. Awesome. So if you followed along, we've built a full credit card recommendation quiz with some really fun elements. We've added badges to it. We've added a custom recommendations based on what the user selected. And let's go all the way through. And we've made it work on mobile. And yeah, I think it's really, really great. So this could be turned into a real business. You would just have to set up the affiliate partnerships with the different credit cards. You'd add the affiliate disclosure. I might actually do this and start testing it out. And you'd want to see what your conversion rate is on the actual quiz. But I think there could be something here in terms of a business of making it fun to have a credit card recommendation quiz. So if you want to learn how to do this or build this on your own, check the link in our description. Go to Lovable. We do earn an affiliate fee if you click on that link and purchase. So we really appreciate you doing that. If you're watching these videos for free, it really helps motivate us and support us to keep making these videos. Check the link in the description to go to No Code MBA if you want to learn more about building with no code and AI tools from start to finish from industry experts. And subscribe to our channel if you want to get more content like this for free. Leave a comment letting us know what else you want to see us build in the future here on YouTube. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.